Check this out.
So we're back, and you're watching the mailbag here on the Dean Show. I'm Yusuf Estes. We've been talking about some of the harsh questions that come to Islam and the misunderstanding that goes with it. And before we wrap up today's program, I want to come back to the subject about the treatment of women again and repeat this. It's not about equality, it's about equity. When they talk about why does a woman have to cover herself up, why does she have to do that? And I ask a woman who seemed to be very upset about the way women are dressed in Islam. I ask her, well, why do you wear clothes at all? And she said, I beg your pardon. I said, well, is it your logic that's telling you that these women are dressed wrong? She said, yes, it is. My logic tells me. I said, well, then according to logic, you shouldn't wear any clothes at all, because logically, you were born with no clothes, so why did you put any on at all? She got upset. She said, modesty. I said, go ask these ladies. They'll tell you it's the same thing. The difference is, instead of letting a human being define what modesty is, they're accepting it from their Lord. Because this is the dress of all of the women of the time of the prophets on back. This is the way Mary dressed, the mother of Jesus, peace be upon him. This is the way that the women of Moses' time is dressed. And these women are doing what? They're covering themselves up, just like nuns cover themselves up. And it's to show these are believing women. And it's also to protect them and protect their beauty from people who don't need to look at them. Their beauty is for their husbands. Their beauty is for their family. And they're protecting themselves according to God's rule and not worrying about human logic. That's an important point. Another thing people talk about is, why is it the women don't have the same things as men do in Islam? Because they're not the same. Where they're the same, it is the same. I'll give you an example off of the pillars of Islam, which we spoke about in another program. First pillar is that you have to say the Shahada and public declaration, I believe there's only one God, and worthy of worship, and Muhammad is his messenger. Man says the same thing as a woman, no difference. The second one is the Salah, to establish our worship. The man prays five times a day, the woman prays five times a day. But a woman does not pray every day out of the month. During her monthly cycle, during her period, she does not pray and she doesn't need to make up those days. So it's different because women are different from men. Now let's go to the next one. The next one is the zakah, the purification of the wealth. A man has to pay 2.5% on his holdings. A woman has to pay 2.5% on her holdings. Why? Because it's the same thing. Both of them are talking about wealth, and there's no difference between a man and a woman when it comes to this. There's not. None are income. And what she holds in for a year, then it's the same as a man's income, what he holds for a year. So there's no difference. So they pay the same. But now let's go to the next one. Let's talk about, what about Ramadan? The month of Ramadan, there's fasting. Fasting every single day through the whole month, but not for the women. For the man, but not the woman. Because again, during her monthly cycle, she doesn't fast those days. She makes them up at another time during the year when it's going to be convenient for her to do so. Then finally is the Hajj. The Hajj is the same for the men and the women, except what? Except the dress. The man wears two towels, the woman can wear the clothes that she likes to wear, because a woman walking around with two towels, that's ridiculous. Plus, she doesn't have to go and do the Hajj if she doesn't have a mahram or a protecting man to go along with her. So this, you can now see, Islam is treating them different because a man is different from a woman. But never is it taking advantage of the woman or taking advantage of the man. Because it's Allah who has come up to this, and it is Allah who has created us, man and woman. And he is the one who's laid this out for us. Does it make sense? I know you've got a lot to say about this. You want to write to me at Yusuf at 99 Islam, and we'll help you to find more of those answers. That's Yusuf at 99islam.com. And always tune in right here to the Dean Show. Until next time, we'll say salams. Peace be upon you.